PN junction. This is the title of today's discussion. Here will explain that first of all, what is this P and N type semiconductor? That means P type semiconductor, N type semiconductor. So, what are these? Semiconductor and how to explain further. So, first of all, that we have to know what is intrinsic semiconductor. So, germanium and silicon are these two. Germanium atomic number Z is equal to 32, and for the silicon it is 14. Right? So, structure, atomic structure with these atomic numbers of these two, silicon and germanium, known as intrinsic semiconductor. When we add some impurity in these two, then impurity may be of trivalent, like aluminium, Z is equal to 13. So, you know that this is 2, 8 and 3. There are 3 electrons in outermost cell, and pentavalent impurity. This is pentavalent impurity, and here I am taking P phosphorus, that Z is equal to 15. And if I write the electronic configuration according to the cell, it will be 2, 8 and 5. This was the 4 cell is equal to 15. So here the atomic structure for the aluminium, this is aluminium first cell, there are 2 electrons, second cell, and there are 8 electrons, and the third one there are only 3 electrons. Right, and similarly, you see here this phosphorus. So, in case of phosphorus, instead of this aluminium, if I consider here 5 phosphorus, then in the third cell there will be 5 electrons. Right, so this is the electronic configuration of the trivalent and pentavalent impurity. Silicon 14 and Z is equal to 13 for the germanium. Now the question was related to the p-type and n-type semiconductor. When one add in these two, if I add here trivalent impurity aluminium, so in both the cases, either in germanium or silicon, then the semiconductor will form of p-type semiconductor. If I add here phosphorus in both these two, then semiconductor will be n-type semiconductor. So in the next section we will see that how the p-type and n-type structure form in the semiconductor. So this was the basic idea of intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor with the concept of trivalent and pentavalent. So thank you.